solid revolution. Now, as we've already discussed, that the area under the curve can be used to estimate the areas of different geometrical shapes. The same thing is about using the areas of using the application of the concept of integration to calculate volumes of solid evolutions. As you can see here, my dear student, in this figure we have here, we are looking at a shape here which we cannot identify the type of shape it is. Now, what we study is that if we allow this particular shape to rotate, now about its axis, as you can see now, we're going to try to do something like a form of rotation for this particular thing to rotate about its particular axis. Now, as this thing is rotating, as you can see, now it will rotate in such a way that it is going to come back to its original position. So during the point of rotation, we can say, for example, that at this particular point, you can also have something like this at this point, which I'm going to draw out like an, let me just say, a kind of shape and look exactly like this, just for understanding's sake. Now, as it is rotating, now we are going to see something like this. So at this point, there will be a rotation of kind of a clockwise rotation, and it's going to be forming something like this about its axis. So it rotates in this manner, diagram not drawn to scale. So now, when it rotates, it's forming something like a solid of revolution. Now, the rotation now can now give us a kind of shape we cannot actually estimate. But from a knowledge of integration, we can actually calculate the volumes of this revolution as it continues to rotate. I have just given out a sample on how the rotation can be. Now, if you look at this shape now, it is very difficult to pick out the type of shape it is. So because of that, we go by what? Taking the part, which is always what we call a very, very small part inside the shape, as we have already studied before. And we take that elemental shape and we just try as much as possible to find the area of that elemental shape. You can see, just like what we've done before, we call this dx. So this is giving us something like a circular elemental revolution, as you can see. So we say it rotates peripherically about its axis. That is the term we use. But to understand this now, we can say, now the area of this elemental shape, as discussed before, we can write that area of elemental shape or elemental disk, anyhow you call it, is always equals to, as we've discussed, we said it has moved by, you can see, both sides, that is y times y, you say y squared, then you have a multiplied by what? That is like length times breadth. So this is y squared multiplied by dx. So we can now say the area of the solid revolution, area of solid revolution, or solids of revolution, can directly be said to be equals to the integration of, we are taking from x1 to x2, we're taking the limit from x1 to x2, here we are integrating y squared dx. So this is the way we actually do that in our, well, I said area, I would say volume. Please excuse me, not area. Volumes. We are dealing with volumes, and that is why volume is always area multiplied by dx. So please, you can always keep that in mind. It's very, very important. So the formula we use is for volume of solid revolution is directly taking an elemental side inside the solid of revolution. We use the integration of limits to get the whole part, as been what has already discussed. Now, to understand this application very well, let us take just one example to understand carefully what we're talking about. Now, we move to the next slide, and here we have, find the volume generated by the curve of y is equals to x squared when it rotates around the x-axis between x is equals to 0 and x is equals to 2. Now, this question was carved out from, I think, UTME, WAHEG, Furthermass, and post-UTME. So I have a series of questions like that that I've solved on my page. You can subscribe to see more. So from what we've discussed, not quite now, we say volume of solid revolution, when it rotates, is given as volume of revolution, is given as integration we are taking from lower limit, as you can see dear student, from 0, which is the lower limit, to 3. We have pi y square, you can see dx. So always keep it in mind, because maybe in the previous page I didn't actually put pi, which is kind of very important, because it is rotating about its x-axis, and you know area of what? Area of a circle is pi r squared. So always keep that in mind. So you can always keep pi as a constant, which is also very important when you are dealing with the formula. So always keep that in mind. Now, coming back here, solving this directly. So we see what we have. So by the formula, we cannot integrate pi. So basically, you can just write it in this form. Integration of, we get pi outside here, taking the limit from 0 to 3. So y squared. Y in this question was given to be x squared. Remember, it was y squared. Then we have r to the power of 3. I hope students understand these steps. So the next step will be doing that directly. We have our pi outside the bracket. We are integrating from 0 lower limits. That will be higher minus lower after the integration of x to the power of 2 times 2 is 4. I hope students know how to do this. So when we integrate, guys, we are going to have this will give us x to the power of 5 over 5. Then we are taking limit. Remember, pi is a constant outside, taking limit from 0 to 3. I hope students get this. So directly we can say we substitute the values, and if we do that, we can just say pi. As you know, that zero will still be zero, so I may just deal with what is here. So I take 3 to the power of 5, let me just show you that, times 3 to the power of 5, because we are taking x to be equals to 3. We've done that a lot, so divided by 5. So I hope students understand this. So our final answer to this should have been upper minus lower limit. Watch all those videos I've done. All these have been discussed already. So 3 to the power of 5 is 243. So we have 243 pi divided by 5. Then answer will be in cubic units. So always keep that in mind. And that is the question answer to it. So guys, I am through with what I want to explain to you guys on basis of integration. I'll see you in the next slide where I take up on limits. I've only tried to do this because of the concept of physics. We need to understand some basic concepts, and that is why I've actually delved into solving questions on that, or teaching the students on how to integrate and differentiate. So guys, if you have any challenges, subscribe to the channel, write email to me, I'll write into you. So see you guys soon. Do have a wonderful time. Bye, and enjoy your day.